All right. 'Twas the night before Christmas when all through Dearbought, not a creature was stirring, not even Kathy Lott. The stockings were hung by the mailbox with care when someone from the HOA said, "You can't put those in." The Cutchies were nestled all snug in their beds, while visions of Becky's cookies danced in their heads. And J Money with her room fan, and Sea Dog with thermal socks, had just figured out how to set our alarm clock. When out on the roof there arose such a clatter, I hobbled on my bad ankles to see what was the matter. Away to the window I flew with a zoom, but first had to make a quick pit stop in the bathroom. The moon on the breast of the new-fallen snow gave the luster of midday to objects below. I could not believe what I saw, but I did. A miniature sleigh and 8 neighborhood kids. With a couple of drivers so lively and quick, I knew in a moment it must be Alex and Nick. More rapid than eagles, the hoodlums they came, and he whistled and shouted and called them by name. Now Jack, now Jason, now Jacob and Ben. On Abby, on Emily, on Brooks and Caitlin. To the top of the porch, to the top of the wall. Watch out for the hoop where they play basketball. I thought to myself, this must be some kind of joke. So I asked Chris, who was outside just taking a smoke. He said Dana might know what they are up to. She'll be up wrapping presents till 2:15.
Dana always leaves.
As dry leaves that before the wild hurricane fly, when they meet with an obstacle, mount to the sky. They flew to the top with a sleigh that was full, thanks to Shelby and a case of cranberry Red Bull. And then in a twinkling, I turned with a shrug and heard the prancing and pawing of all their new Uggs. As I drew in my head and was turning around, down the chimney, Alex and Nicholas came with a bound. They were dressed all in fur from their head to their feet, and their dog Jake was with them looking for something to eat. A bundle of toys they had flung on their back, and down came their helpers, Jason and Jack. Nick's eyes, how they twinkled, his dimples, how merry. His cheeks were like roses, his nose like a cherry. He seemed very nice, though that wasn't always the case. He said, "Sometimes I just want to punch you all in the face."
Oh my god!
His stump of a pipe he held tight in his teeth, and the smoke it encircled his head like a wreath.
Oh my god.
He had quick little feet and was as tall as a tower. On the court, he could probably stuff Sophia Bowers. He was chubby and plump, a right jolly old tart. And the scent that surrounded him was the vague smell of a fart. with a wink of his eye and a slight smudge of cinder, I knew for him I would swipe right on Tinder. He spoke not a word and started moving slower. He was tired from lugging a brand new snowblower.
I knew you were gonna say that.
And laying his fingers aside one another, up the chimney Alex stuffed his younger brother. An old man from Dearbought, who was known to be mean, saw the entire group as they were leaving the scene. The old man exclaimed as they took off with a blast, "Happy Christmas to all! Slow down, you're driving too fast!"